Okay, so I'm Sudeshna. I'm a graduate student in the Department of Biology, Boston College. My lab is interested in studying an organism called Toxoplasma gondii, and this is pretty prevalent, I would say, because about one third of the world population is infected with this organism. But in healthy individuals, it's mildly symptomatic or mostly asymptomatic. But when the immune system of an individual is compromised, this disease manifests itself, and sometimes this can lead to severe consequences. And the other thing is that if a person gets infected, it develops a chronic latent infection in it.
This is the media that we have.
So yeah, and we are studying the fast replicating form of this parasite, which is responsible for the manifestation of the disease. And we are studying how this parasite interacts with the host, how it goes in, comes out, how it multiplies inside the host cells and stuff like that. Specifically, if you ask me what got me into this part of the science, where I would like to know how parasite interacts, it's like I was always fascinated by how these tiny organisms, they manage to infect us. And even with our development in science and all, we still fall sick. We still don't have answers to so many questions that these microorganisms impose on our faces. And when I got an opportunity as a graduate student to know something about it, I thought that this is my chance. I would just like to do it. I'm looking at invasion, which is how the parasite goes inside the host cell, and how the parasite comes out, which is egress of the parasite. And I'm studying three proteins, and I'm trying to figure out how these proteins are involved in those processes.
What we see here is these are some of the flasks of different sizes. This is our baby flask. Each of these flasks has a host cell monolayer in there, and then when we infect those host cells with parasites, those parasites gradually infect them, grow in those parasites. And as I mentioned, these parasites are obligate intracellular parasites, so it needs to have a host cell for its growth and for its survival. So that's what we do here.
These parasites, they can go in any nucleated cell. The way this parasite goes in, we are starting to know about it, but still there are so much things that we still don't know. So I'm mostly trying to figure out how the three proteins that I'm working on assist this process, or what role they play during this this phase of the parasite. Well, the first and the foremost is that we would know more about the biology of this organism, and knowing the biology of the organism is important, because in that case we can think about the preventive measures, what are the targets that we can define, and we can try to develop drugs or therapeutic measures to block those steps or in the process, because there is no very efficient drug treatment for this parasite yet. So knowing the biology would actually not just help the biology of this organism, but also its related organisms. For example, Toxoplasma is very related to Plasmodium, which is the causative agent of malaria. So knowing Toxoplasma would help treating and understanding the biology of Toxoplasma, as well as the biology of these other epicomplexans parasites. And those would actually in turn help us to develop some preventive measures, and those would lead to the benefit of other people.